Army from 1978 to 1981.
He was a kind of a big biker guy. I was kind of afraid of him when I first met him, and then I got to know him, and he ended up being one of the nicest guys I've ever met. He's got an awesome personality, really nice guy. Obviously, or I wouldn't be married to him for 20 years. I don't really know what they were caused by. They had suggested the hospital in Chicago where he had a second back surgery, said that maybe it was caused by the anesthetic because he was under for so long. We were on I-90 coming home from Chicago, and I had to pull off over to the side. We didn't even know that it was a seizure at that time. We didn't know what it was.
The seizures would take me for a week, and then it'd take me a week or so longer to get out of from being down. And then after a couple weeks of that, it'd start all over again.
And it could go on for a couple days, two or three a day, and then he's just in bed. He can't get up. He can barely eat. His whole body hurt from the seizures. It just debilitated him. He would be in bed for days.
And it whooped me bad.
It was hard. It was really hard. The kids were living at home. The kids were small at the time. We just dealt with it.
Anybody who has a diagnosis of epilepsy first gets treated with medications. And they often are very effective and without side effects. However, sometimes they don't work. And actually, in about a third of patients, medications will not control a person's seizures.
When you start a new medication, it takes maybe 3 weeks to a month to even get into your system to even know if it's going to work. And then if that doesn't work, you're back to square one again, trying something new. So it got to be frustrating for everybody.
When a person has epilepsy that is medically intractable, often we recommend performing surgery to reduce the amount of seizures they are having. For example, many patients with medically intractable epilepsy have seizures that emanate from the temporal lobe, which is a portion of the brain behind the eyes. By removing either this section of the temporal lobe or a smaller section of the temporal lobe, it may reduce or completely eliminate the seizures that someone is having.
Hello, Mr. Hood.
How are you doing?
Mr. Hood, how are you all doing?
When the doctor started talking about surgery, it was pretty scary. We didn't see that there was any other alternative because he'd already been through all the medications that they could give him.
And I was at the point where it didn't matter because I was down more than I was up. So I was willing to do anything at the time.
Epilepsy surgery, like all types of surgery, has risk. The risk of stroke, the risk of bleeding, infection, and of course there's even a risk of death.
The actual risks are quite low. The risk of death is small, would be very similar to any surgical procedure. There's a small risk of infection, and those risks are quite low, well less than 1%.
The only time we do epilepsy surgery is if someone's seizures are poorly controlled with medication. And when we choose to do that, we actually feel that the surgery is less risky than not having the surgery. Because if they don't have the surgery for their epilepsy, they continue to have ongoing and uncontrolled seizures.
And there is an inherent risk to uncontrolled epilepsy that can result in death.
He really didn't have any alternative other than life the way he knew it, or life the way maybe it could be afterwards. There was a lot of testing going on, but I guess they did what they had to do.
The epilepsy monitoring unit is the section here in the hospital where we can bring patients in, get them all hooked up with the EEG leads so that we can see the brain waves, and then monitor them when they have a seizure. That data will help the doctors decide where the seizure is coming from, what part of the brain it's coming from, what kind of a seizure it is, and therefore what kind of treatment is going to work best.
So overall, we think that epilepsy surgery and a temporal lobectomy would be the way to go on the left side.
If somebody is going to have surgery and we're going to take out part of their brain, that neurosurgeon wants to know exactly where to go and exactly what to take out.
The testing that we do not only allows us to find the abnormal area of brain, it also allows us to assess how functional that portion of the brain is. I think we should do a left side of the anterior temporal lobectomy. He is left-handed, so he does seem to have language function on both sides.
What we don't want to do is not make the seizures go away and then have someone have a new problem in addition to that that may be just as disabling.
Patients usually come in for surgery first thing in the morning. They'll undergo surgery, which will last somewhere between often 4 to 6 hours, so it is a long surgery.
So when he had his surgery, he actually had it awake, and we stimulated areas of the temporal lobe to see whether or not language lived there, if you will, and tried to avoid those areas to minimize any problem.
And then you wake you up and during the surgery, and it's like, it's pretty wild when you're awake, when they're up here.
It was really scary, just waiting and worrying.
Some patients may report some changes in their speech or some changes in their memory. Other patients may experience some weakness or fatigue. In most patients, this improves with a rehabilitation program or with time.
Are you having any problems right now, or things going all right?
They're going all right with the same old.
Okay.
If carefully selected, epilepsy patients usually have good outcomes, and they'll have some improvement in their seizures, and some patients will have a complete elimination of their seizures.
Before the surgery, I wasn't able to do anything.
And now that he's had the surgery and everything is good, we do a lot together. We can go out with our friends. We can go do with the horses. We work in the yard together. We go on hikes. We do a lot now.
If epilepsy surgery is successful, it can provide a lot of rewards to patients. If they're having fewer seizures or no seizures, they have greater comfort in their life, greater safety. It's an absolute game changer.
The surgery got my life back, so yes on the surgery.
The surgery changed our whole family's life, absolutely.
It worked, that's all I know.